What's it like flying for the first time in India as a foreigner after the pandemic? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you everything from the check-in process to the situation at the airport and of course the whole flying experience. Hi, my name is Ivana and I live in Bangalore. Prior to the pandemic, I used to take a flight very frequently. Every single week or every 2 weeks was definitely not an exception. But the last flight that I took in the past year was on the 12th of January 2020. So it has been a minute. In the meantime, obviously a lot of things have changed. So I was very curious to see what the flight experience in India looks like now after the pandemic. And I'm quite sure a lot of you guys might be interested to see that as well. If you will be traveling soon yourself, you will be able to see what it looks like and what you can expect. Or if you know somebody who is going to be traveling or who plans to travel, make sure to send this video to them so they know what to expect. Without further ado, let's start our journey in the car on the way to the airport. Prior to the pandemic, I wouldn't mind checking in at the airport because I always have check-in baggage. However, in the current situation, it's best to make sure you move as fast as possible. So, as we're driving to the airport, I'm already checked in online and have a digital boarding pass on my phone. Pro tip, make a screenshot of your boarding pass so you also have it as a picture on your phone in case your reception suddenly drops and you can't access your email. As we are approaching the airport, I'm definitely nervous. India is a crowded country, so they have never allowed non-passengers to enter the airport in order to prevent crazy crowds. Nevertheless, with just passengers in the airport, it still used to be crowded. How would this work with social distancing? My first impression of the security entrance to the airport is pretty good. It's not ideal social distancing, but I also don't feel people are completely cramped up. Also, there is an added display which indicates the waiting time at the check-in counters per airline. It's great added information for timing your check-in if you have check-in luggage. What I love most about the security entrance to the airport is that the staff is all behind glass and they check your boarding pass and ID behind it. The same is the case at the check-in counters. There's a glass shield between you and the airline staff checking you in. Also, the staff that directs you to the counter is wearing full PPE and most passengers are conscious about decent social distancing. I feel huge relief sinking into me and my nerves definitely relax more seeing how much precautions have been taken by the airline and the airport. But I'm not fully at ease because security check is always the most crowded and cramped up area in any airport. Would it be possible to social distance? Would the security officer be touching my phone to see my boarding pass? Is everybody wearing a mask? As we're approaching the security check, I do get a bit tense because even though it's definitely not as cramped up as before, social distancing is less than entering the airport or checking in. I am relieved, however, to again see security standing behind a glass screen and not touching your phone to check your boarding pass. I'm also very relieved to see every single passenger wearing a mask and at least trying to social distance, even though in this area it's really difficult because there's less space for everybody. Also, the signs around us about how the items which are touched a lot are sanitized and restaurants showing contactless ordering give me more and more comfort. In the airport, there's plenty of sanitizers around you, but also the chairs in the sitting areas are all well marked for social distancing. It's phenomenal to see almost every single passenger sticking to this. So when you pass security, the social distancing is actually way easier than I ever imagined. I love seeing that and it's incredibly reassuring. Once the boarding starts, like always, I'd recommend anybody to wait until the first crowds clear out. The people coming in a bit later are usually more laid back and will keep more distance. The scanning of the boarding pass is contactless and the staff gives everybody a PPE kit. Once passing the boarding pass scan, there's plenty of space to put on the PPE gear. Passengers sitting in the middle will be given additional PPE gear to put over their clothes, but as Neha and me were sitting at the window and the aisle side, this was not applicable for us. As we walk into the boarding bridge, we witness a gorgeous sunset and it's really a moment of counting your blessings. Look how far we've all made it, that flying is possible again. It's such an uplifting sight as we progress to a usually incredibly cramped up space, the boarding of the aircraft. However, it's much less cramped than I expect and I can see people consciously making an effort to social distance however much the space allows. This is definitely different once you enter the airplane. It's simply impossible to social distance because the space doesn't allow it. Nevertheless, it's hugely comforting to see all staff wearing PPE and most passengers with a mask and a shield. Upon reaching my seat, I breathe a large breath of relief. It's not a perfect process, but I can see so many precautions being taken to minimize the risk of infection. The breathing with a shield and a mask is also not as bad as I expected. As long as you remain calm and don't speak, it's perfectly fine. Speaking with your neighbor is anyways restricted because of the shield blocking quite a lot of sound. So any introvert can sigh a breath of relief. We had a very friendly neighbor in Krishna though. That magical moment, the plane lifts off, I'm pinching myself that flying is possible again. 2020 was undoubtedly a shock to all of us, turning our lives upside down and restricting us in unimaginable ways. As I see Bangalore slowly sliding away under us, massive privileges like flying being an option again gives so much hope for the future.
You can just wave.
I don't know if you believe in symbolism, but seeing the sunset on this first flight in over more than a year makes me feel like we're closing a dark chapter. Goa Airport is less than 45 minutes of flying from Bangalore. While we land, however, I can't help getting a bit fearful again. Upon landing, there's usually a very intense group of people who stand in the aisles before the plane doors even open. For anybody having the same fears as me, here's another pro tip. You won't be faster out of the plane if you stand in the aisle. The solution is very simple. Remain in your seat until most people clear and you'll be able to walk out in one go.
So even though we used to travel a lot,
yeah.
It does feel like a little abnormal.
Oh, a little?
Yeah.
Look at what we're wearing. It would not be something that I would be doing like every month.
Yeah.
Or every week, like we used to.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah.
Overall, looking back at my first flight experience in India after the pandemic as a foreigner, I would say that I am very much comforted by going through this experience. I absolutely love the contactless check-in process. Also at the airports, I thought it would be very hard to social distance, but I feel a lot of people do keep those regulations in mind. Definitely a massive difference between airlines. On our way from Goa back to Bangalore, we flew a different airline. They were definitely not particular about giving out the PPE. And when we even asked about the PPE, the girl was so casual about it. She was like, oh, only if you feel comfortable with it. And I was like, this is not about comfort. This is about safety and staying healthy. So I was definitely not amused. Now, I'm not going to name and shame the airline because I feel the airline business has suffered more than enough due to the pandemic. However, I am going to make you a very hard recommendation to only fly IndiGo because they are extremely meticulous with the COVID rules. So I felt a lot more safer on board of an IndiGo flight than on the other airline. This is not sponsored, by the way. I just want you to be safe and sound if you are traveling. And of course, I would love to hear you guys' experiences as well. Let me know down in the comments below if you have already taken a flight in India and what your experience was. If you haven't taken a flight yet, let me know if you are planning on taking a flight and if this video helped. If you liked the video, make sure to put a thumbs up. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.